Good morning, everybody. This is breakfast time again. Happy new week. Happy stress-free week in Jesus Christ's name. Let's just say a word of prayer. So everlasting Father, we bless you. We give you glory. We thank you for the blessedness of this new day. Thank you, Lord, for waking us up in the name of Jesus. Father, as you have woke us up, oh God, Father, we embrace your new mercies, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, this day, oh God, keep us holy for you in Jesus Christ's name. Lord, guide our tongue, guide our hearts, and deliver us from every form and manner of temptation today in the name of Jesus. Everlasting Father, breathe upon your word that is able to save and to deliver and grant us deeper understanding in Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Without wasting much time, I just want to quickly, let's see the book of First John chapter 2, verse 14 and verse 15 and 16. It says here, First John 2, 15 and 16, do not love the world or the things in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, the pride of life, is not of the Father, but of this world. Praise Master Jesus. And we know what the lust of the flesh. What are the fruit of the flesh? The Bible says in the book of Galatians, chapter 5, from verse 19, makes us to understand that the works of the flesh are being manifested: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulation, wrath, strife, seduction, heresies, envy, murder, drunkenness, revelings, and so much, so on and so on. He said those that participate in this, that practice this, that have this in their inside, will not inherit the kingdom of God. And today I want to take it little by little. What is lost? That strong feelings, that strong passion that you have, but in the negative way towards something. Praise Master Jesus. And the Bible makes us to understand, you know, when Jesus was telling us, these are the things that defies us. When we look at the book of, the book of James, chapter 1, 14, 15, he was telling us, is our lust that has dragged us, our desire. So lust can also be called desire, can also be called what you wish for, what you long for, what you yearn for, what you hunger for, what you taste for, what you pant for, is strong feelings in you. Praise Master Jesus. And today I want to, under the lust of the flesh, I want to talk about sexual lust. Praise Master Jesus. You know, today many of us, we confuse this sexual lust. Something you hear, especially maybe among the youth, even the married people, they tell you is love. Many of them is not love, it's just lust. Praise Master Jesus. And most times what I have seen that is the cause of lust, some of the cases are, you are not contented, lack of contentment. You are not contented, you are not satisfied. For example, to the married people, the Bible makes us to understand you should drink water from your own well. Drink water from your own well. Praise Master Jesus, from your own system. But today, even the married people are caught in this web also. Praise Master Jesus. And we see this lust everywhere. We see this whole event everywhere. And most times, how does this thing comes into our heart? It's through the eyes. Because your eyes, the Bible says in the book of Matthew, I think 6:22, make us to understand that our eyes is a lamp. So it, through the lamp that is in your body, which is the eyes, it comes into your heart. And many a times we just console ourselves as Christian, I didn't do it anyway. I didn't lay with her. I didn't. But in your heart, and Jesus was telling them in the book of Matthew, that when you lost in your heart, you have already committed it. You are as guilty as the one that laid with the person. Praise the Lord. So today, I want to look at a particular person in the Bible that did the same thing we are talking about, lust of the flesh. Praise Master Jesus. On that sexual, having lust after a woman because of the lust of the flesh. Praise Master Jesus. Who is King the person of King David in the book of Second Samuel chapter 11. The Bible makes us to understand when you read from verse 1. It says it was a time when the kings do go to war, but this particular day David sent Joab and his servant and all Israel to go to war while he was at home, relaxing in the couch in his house. He said that he got up from the couch and walked on the roof of his house and saw a woman taking a bath called Bathsheba. And the Bible makes us to understand in verse 3, he sent somebody to inquire of her. So this will tell us when the person came with full details. This is Bathsheba, the daughter of Elam, the wife of Uriah, the Hittite, peradventure, who you sent to war. Let me paraphrase it. Who you sent to war. And that did not stop David. But do you know what the next verse, David said, he ordered them to bring her. And he lay with her, knowing fully where this is. What am I trying to say? Lust is programmed to disorganize us and distract us from the blueprint of Christ, of God. So lust, if we don't deal with it, is going to ruin us. Lust, if we don't deal with it, is going to ruin us. Many a times we say it's nothing. You know, I will tell you, Samson lusted after Delilah, because which man will be in love when the woman is telling you, tell me what is the source of your strength and hide me, I ruin you. And you just laugh over it. Lust blinds our heart from the truth. Lust is a killer. If we don't identify it on time, it's going to kill us. It's going to ruin us. And I pray that's not our portion in Jesus' name. Today, even children of God, we participate in it unknowingly. And the devil brings it into us subtly. You know, I like cars, especially when I see very good ones, new ones. You know, I cannot remember the phrase I normally use. My husband always, when I mean always, when I say it, you hear him shout, baby, this is covetousness. Honey, this is covetousness. I say, but I'm just joking now. I say, we should just swap. You should have my own and I have his own. I say, this is covetousness. Baby, you're lusting over. Just be contented. God will bring. I said, but I am joking. He said, no, that joke is not good. Don't joke with that again. Praise the Lord. Gradually, he has not said it 10 times. He has not said it 50 times. In fact, I have lost count. Whenever I say it, if he's there, he's going to tell me something. Praise the Lord. And to the glory of God, I see that I'm minimizing it. But this sexual lust, at times, even in church, we pack ourselves, the way we pack ourselves to church. Brother is us inside the church, is already committing something else inside the church. Praise Master Jesus. So I want us to deal with it. Yes, you might not have lay with the person, but you've already lusted in your heart with the person. What are you doing? You've also committed lust. So let us go, as we go through this week, let's put our desire in check. Let's bring it under check. When you see the desire, quickly run to the book of Galatians. Is it in line with what God is saying? Is it the works of the flesh or the works of the Holy Spirit that is in us? And I pray as we go through this week that God will help us to live for Him alone. God will keep us. God will deliver us from this power of lust that is set out to destroy us in the name of Jesus. So have a peaceful week, a stress-free one, a fulfilled week in Jesus' name. God bless you and God keep you firm. Still, we meet again next week in Jesus Christ's name. Bye-bye for now. Hallelujah.